this was a solid wall. There was nothing here. It was a temporary piece that you moved in. It was over there. The wall was filled. There was a regular doorway here and a door. And our designer and Jerry together and me kind of went back and forth. We came up with this design. So the support that you saw in the basement happens to support this. This and up there, this is all filling in a crossbeam. And you can see the different supports in the basement that are supporting the rafters that were put in. So the size of that is up to this point almost, in the same way here. Jerry arranged for the furniture to be made. That's all of this, and whatever you see in the kitchen. We worked for our decorator, not Jerry, to get the marble. But Jerry measured everything, went back and forth with the Amish people, who were wonderful. And they just brought everything in one day after Jerry's measurements. So that really worked out well.
And all fit pretty nicely?
I didn't see any problem, but they knew that they left for adjustments, and Jerry could make those adjustments if there was, because of course it's going to be a half an inch, a quarter of an inch, something or other. And there was that, which I didn't see. The art piece is my wife's.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And then the kitchen was completely, that's the kitchen, was down to the studs. And Jerry had arranged for the blown-in, semi-solid, cell-based insulation. And that was all done after he pulled out everything. And everything else is new in the kitchen that we'll go in and see. He arranged for the plumbing, he arranged for the lighting. All the lighting was his, through his people. This design was, you know, which I really like, having these books available on this curve. If you come over here, I can show you how these pull out. Well, we can look maybe at the whole kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
This is an old house, about 110 years old. So this all belongs to the Amish people made all of these wooden cabinets. They were really good. I'm really happy with them. They pull out.
Pretty high quality cabinets?
I would consider them to be very high quality, yes. Yes. And storage, different kinds. We went to, we actually stayed at Jerry's bed and breakfast and met the Amish people from there. Selected the wood and then everything else. This is a fireplace, old fireplace. All of these pull out. They all catch when you push and close. So all of these cabinets in here were through the Amish guys. We bought this ourselves. Jerry had this put in. My wife has her desk here now. We love this. This piece of wood comes from the designers again. It's not that we use it as a pass-through, but the open feeling of having this, and our decorator, that was not Jerry, but he might have come up with the same idea. So the decorator recommended it, and just sitting in that room makes it feel very much open.
Was your decorator and Jerry, did they get along? Were they easy to work together with, the three of you?
Jerry is easy to get along with, and our decorator is, because that's the kind of people we are. I'm not going to take somebody who's not good and comfortable to work with. But I pretty much went between them. They may have talked once or twice, but it was me, and I wanted to be in the middle. I like to know what's happening. I'm an engineer. I'm kind of specific about things.
Mm-hmm.
This was, this was down to the rafters. We had a bathroom here, but it was completely different, and Jerry fit this wall in. So there was no wall here at all. Everything was stripped. This whole kitchen was completely down to the bare wood, the rafters. And this, again, is storage.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
How about this floor? This looks original.
Oh, yeah. You know what happened when you remember the floor, because I think you were here.
I was here.
But Jerry was bought the wood to put down. And on top of it was linoleum, old linoleum, and some blackened stuff that was on the floor. When Jerry came to this point and removed the other, he realized, hey, you have a good wooden floor. So this floor matches the other floor because it is the same. When Jerry realized that, it was not, I didn't have to convince him. He just took the wood back to Home Depot and returned it. And,
well, you can't buy an authentic floor like that at Home Depot.
No.
That's beautiful.
Right. And, you know, all these, we had holes in the floor. Jerry just had his people work to close those up. The appliances, of course, we bought and had done. Working with the Amish guys, they supplied this without the glass, and we had the glass put in. Well, they gave us a different kind of glass, just plain white. Mm-hmm. We had this arranged and it was put in. All of these, we go up to the ceiling with our cabinets, which really is a lot more space than we had before. And this one is like that, came like that. We didn't have to do that.
So, if I understand, Jerry took the time to take you to go visit the Amish, and you...
No. He arranged and gave us a free night at his bed and breakfast.
Oh.
And then that's about 4 or 5 miles from the Amish.
Mm-hmm.
We met them in the morning, arranged for the kind of wood, the general kind of cabinet material, the design of the wood. And you notice on the side as well.
Mm-hmm.
And then over time we selected the piece sizes. So everything could be made to fit. And that's pretty much the way it was done. I don't know if you saw the side over here, which is also open. You saw where the books were on the other side, but there's this nice opening here. Mm-hmm. And these are... We keep kosher, so we have our dairy here. This is our dairy silverware. Our meat's on this side. Our meat pots are on this side. So it all works to what we need.
Mm-hmm.
But Jerry he's easy to work with. When something goes awry and you have a problem with it, he works it out. And when he gives a price, the price is the price at the end is the same as the price at the beginning. It's not like he keeps changing. I was impressed with the place he built where his bed and breakfast is. It's all really fits together and it's really beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
So the fans were, we ordered the fans and they were put in by the electricians. Controlled in 3 steps by this switch, these switches. The lighting, we talked to Jerry and he then talked to the lighting people.
Are you happy with the result?
I am thrilled with the result.
It all turned out the way you wanted it?
Yeah, we live here for 1973, 13, like almost 40 years. And up until this time, the kitchen was the same. Maybe a few cabinets would change, but this is really redo. The other thing was, this is a steam. The heating we have is a gas burner down in the basement, and it sends up steam. It's not water that goes through, so the steam comes in and gets released, but there's no exit. It's not like it's not like hot water. It's steam heat, which comes through the radiator. Well, we had a bigger radiator, and I was worried because there's problems that you can have where the radiators will bang if they're not balanced properly with the steam systems. So told Jerry my concern and stuff. He went home, asked some people, understood it well enough. He came back and says, this should be fine. So I think the plumbing person arranged for the place to get the smaller steam radiator. Our previous radiator was like about 2 feet longer, and this was fine. The insulation on the window on the room is excellent, and above it is also, this was all the way up, there's a slanted roof above this. So this ceiling was not here. The blown insulation is up there and on the side, so the insulation is really good.
Good.
We're pleased with it, yes.
So all in all, would you be happy to recommend Jerry for someone who wants to remodel their house?
Well, you're his brother, but I'll say what I want to say. He's great.